Yeah. Shut it. I know what you mean.
And join the Gab Fam, it's fun over here. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you for coming back. I really appreciate you guys. So, as you can see, slightly different room, slightly different environment. I am in Dominica. I am so happy to be here. I'm happy to be home, but I'm actually in Dominica for work. Like, that's crazy. Yeah. Like, my job flew me out here, literally put me up in Fortune Hotel, so beautiful. Of course, I must still spend a little time by my mommy, you know, on the weekend and stuff like that. Or actually, maybe make her come here. I think that would be like really nice for a change of environment. I saw her last night though, so you're so excited to see me. So cute. So I'm here I almost said Jamaica. I'm here in, I think you might hear a little bit of construction. So yeah, I'm here in Fortune Hotel, as I would have shown you guys. Really beautiful in here. I actually love this painting. It's by a Dominican artist. I think it's Shadi. So this is a painting from Shadrach. So I just love how they've incorporated like Dominican arts into the rooms, as well as like all these old maps. And in case you did not know, I'm literally a geographic information system specialist. My master's degree is in geospatial science. I'm a big geography nerd in my 9-to-5. So seeing these old maps, and they have different maps in all the rooms, and I just think this is so beautiful. Okay, so I hope this is working and you guys can hear me properly. I finally got the cord from the Apple store to be able to connect my mic to my phone. So I hope you hear my audio much better and not the construction. But like I was saying, I am staying at Fortune Hotel. It's like one of Dominica's like most prestigious and probably one of their oldest hotels. So Fortune Hotel, severely damaged during the hurricane, like 90% of the buildings in Dominica. And since Hurricane Maria, they've been renovating and expanding. So they renovated like the other older part of the hotel all by the seaside. They renovated the restaurants and so on. It's really beautiful. And then this part of the hotel, the upper part, they also expanded and went up. So I think the top two floors are not done yet, but the three floors below that, so I'm on the third floor, and the three floors below that are basically, they're being used. They're still renovating, so there's still like little things that they're like adding, you know, signs and different things like that. But more or less the rooms are done, and there are other guests on my floor and everything like that as well. But it's so beautiful, like it's just so stunning. I'm just seeing some people going out to dive. That's really nice. They have a really good like dive center right there. Yeah. Oh, by the way, do you guys like my frames? So these frames are actually from Bohten. I'm gonna get my prescription put in them. So last night I went over by my mom, and I was just like diving through my stuff. So I like rummaging through my stuff sometimes, because it's almost like sometimes I go shopping in my own closet. So, and then I put together a whole bag of stuff so that my mom can give it away. I don't know what it is, but my brother and I always play in tag team when it comes to Dominica. Sometimes I will be here and then leave,
and he will end up coming here like a month after. But needless to say, he's always leaving me little gifts, sometimes taking some of my stuff, but that's okay. As a digital marketing company, by the way, so that's a little plug for my brother. So if you are looking for a digital marketing agency, you can hit up Dominate Digital. I will put down their link in my bio. Free plug for my little brother. Yeah. But he does marketing with this brand called Bohten. I think they actually came out with a line of glasses, even for like when the Wakanda special came out. I saw these in my room and I tried them on. I was like, these are so cute. How I was literally just looking for a new pair of glasses because about last week or so, I went to the eye doctor just to check on my eyes because I hadn't gotten an eye test in like 2 years and really should check your eyes like every year. I don't often vlog with my glasses just because my glasses have like blue lights, so sometimes there's a lot of reflection. My right eye is so much worse than it was before. Both my eyes are worse, but my right eye is just like so bad. And I sent my brother a picture and I was like, these are mine now. And go look up Bohten because I love them. I'm definitely getting my prescription in them. And I don't usually like these like big angular glasses, but I like these. I feel like they just complement my skin tone so well. And then I love the tortoise with a nice little design. It just looks different, you know? Yeah, so I woke up early. I just finished getting dressed and ready. I need to run off and pay for one or two things, and then I'm gonna come back to the hotel, have some food, and do some work and prep and all that for tomorrow. So in terms of like this whole few days that I will be here, we have like some field stuff to do in the coming days, some site visits, and then but the major day that we came here for is like happening tomorrow. So I'm gonna be really busy with that today, but I just said I'm gonna come on and say hey. If I'm gonna find some kind of Dominican breakfast, right? I need some baked sand codfish, some something like that, you know, some something. I'm gonna jet off now and talk to you guys soon.
This is so just beautiful and calming. I love it.
Hello guys, so it is currently Thursday and I just got back to my room. I had a very successful morning and a very good morning with work. Oh my god, there's a guy snorkeling outside. I just love Dominica. Like when I tell you I just love Dominica, I'm just here sitting on my hotel room looking out at the ocean and there's a random person snorkeling. They're just snorkeling and diving right outside, right in these waters. Like, it's beautiful. We're so blessed, honestly. It's lunchtime now. I have one or two little errands that I want to run, so I'm going to go ahead and do them on lunch, take you guys with me. But so far so good. My morning has been great and yeah, like, isn't that just so dope? My friend's dad actually runs the dive shop that's at Fortune. So if you guys ever come to Fortune and you want to dive, check them out. Antonia, I'm having a passion fruit martini and wow, it's delicious. Deliciously strong though. What are you drinking?
Shirley Temple.
Shirley Temple. She looks so cute. Look at my little Jamaican Dominican friend now. You well Dominican.
So we're having dinner at hotel. So yeah, This drink is delicious, by the way.
Beautiful day. There's a fisherman out on his boat. We just love the island life.
So something that I noticed this morning when I was getting ready, that the words on the shower door is actually the first stanza of Dominica's national anthem. I just love that. Like, I really, really, really love that. So I had to show it.
Hi guys. So I am just here about to go in the field. So I'm going to take you guys with me. But I stopped at Julian's Jewelry on Lunchtime because I literally brought gold to them yesterday. This is like just mismatched gold that I had, like one side of earrings. Maybe I lost the other side. Stuff that a chain that I had from my grandmother. I brought it to them yesterday. They called me this afternoon. It was already done. I was like, oh my God. But I made like a matching bracelet. You can probably see like which one is the new one. Let me come in the light. And which one is the old one, because the new one is like shinier, but the new one is the one that's kind of like open. But how beautiful. I love these.
Let me show you guys in better lighting, but aren't they just beautiful? One, the first one, I made it when my grandmother on my dad's side died. I mixed some of her gold and my gold, and I made a bracelet kind of like as a way to commemorate her and just, you know, have that little sentimental piece on my hand every day. And then I just made the other one. How pretty, just so stunning. The local craftsmanship, locally made, like, wow. Today, because we're starting the afternoon, because my coworker had meetings this morning, so because we're starting off in the afternoon, we're going to head down south because we have less sites in the south, and then we'll do the north on Monday. Okay, so I'm at Scott's Head getting some field data. Oh my god, there's so much snorkeling and stuff there. I can't believe I've never gone snorkeling in Dominica. Can you believe it? I think it's because I'm slightly a wimp and think that I need to be like a super strong swimmer to snorkel, but you actually don't.
I definitely need to come back and do these sort of fun things in Amigo.
But look at this. Atlantic Ocean.
Hey, please recognize I'm trying.
Okay, so I'm at Scott's Head.
lovely people. It's a makeupless Saturday, but I'm just here in front of Pearl's Cuisine. I just collected my mixed broth. I called and ordered it because they go so quickly. They have bullfoot soup too. I was thinking about the bullfoot soup, but I was like, nah, I want a mixed broth, because if it's one thing, I don't eat red meat, but every time I come to Dominica, I have to have a mixed broth with some pig snout and some fish and maybe some smoked meat and dumplings and cock hoy and dash. Such a rainy day today. I haven't been able to get a lot of superb content because I haven't really been outside. I've just been in the hotel room all morning. It's literally now almost 3 o'clock. I'm probably just gonna go back to the hotel to eat this, and yeah, I'm just gonna continue on with my day.
Yes, it's glorious. Yum 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 yum. So I was feeling for some sweets. I just ordered this chocolate brownie. Looks really good. And some vanilla ice cream. Man, the amount of dairy I've eaten in Dominica, like, I'm probably gonna suffer for the next week, but it's all good. It's all, I don't know why. It originally came in two plates. Like, they put the ice cream in a separate plate. I'm like, why? I literally asked for a scoop of ice cream and a brownie. But anyway.
Cheers!
Sunday with Antonia and Joshy Josh. Big up the bartender, the drinks have been great! What's your name?
Duran.
Duran?
Duran?
Yes. Okay, so big up Duran every time you come to Puerto Hotel. Our drinks have been great.
Woo! Roast corn, roast corn, roast corn.
Thank you. It's so good. Thank you, no problem.
Let's go get your side. Yes.
Can I put half a milk, my youth?
Mm-mm. Mm-mm. Welcome, I'm good. Oh my god, it's so good. You didn't want one, right?
No.
Mm. Wow.
Send me your location, let's focus on communication, cause I just need the time and place to come through. Send me your location, let's ride the vibration. I don't need nothing else but you. At times I wonder why I fall with you, but this is new to me, this is new to you. Initially, I didn't wanna fall for you, gather my attention, it was all for you. So don't take advantage, don't leave my heart damaged. I understand that things go a little bit better when you panic. Oh, so would you say to me, location, let's focus on communication, cause I just need the time and place to come through. Send me your location, let's ride the vibrations. I don't need nothing else, but I don't fall in love off a step sweet, so let's get personal. I got a lot of cool spots that we can go. Tell me what's the move, and I got you. I'm only acting like this cause I
It's afternoon time now, so we are out on the field doing some site visits today. So we started from the south and we just got to Portsmouth, so we're pretty much like at the top. So now we're gonna go get lunch at Toucarie and keep it moving.
Tonight, I don't need nothing else but you.
wanting to get lobster so bad from Keeping It Real, but it's not gonna be ready for another hour and a half, 2 hours.
At times I wonder why I fall with you, but this is new to me, this is new to you initially. I didn't wanna fall, but you gather my attention, it was all for you. So don't take advantage, don't keep my heart damaged. I understand that things go a little bit better when you panic. Oh, so would you send me your location, let's focus on communicating, cause I just need the time and place to come through. Location, the vibrations, I don't need nothing else, but I don't want to fall in love off a step sweet, so let's keep personal. I got a lot of cool spots that we can go. Tell me what's the move and I got you. I'm only acting like this cause I like you. Just give me the vibe to slide in. Oh, I might make you mine by the night then. Location, on communicating, cause I just need all time and place to come through. Send me your location, let the vibrations, I don't need.
All right, last camera action.
So would you send me your location, let's focus on communicating, cause I just need all time and place to come through.
Cheers. Oh wow, the drinks look so pretty.
Good morning, you guys. It is such a beautiful day and I leave today. I am both happy for the weather and so sad because I wish this was the weather on Sunday. I would have had such an amazing day, but life happens.
I got me my Bakx. I'm very content with my life right now. Very content.
All right, guys. Quick get ready with me for the airport. I just want to look cute, but I kind of want my makeup to last today because I land at 6 p.m. and as soon as I land and I get my stuff to the hotel, I'm heading straight to the mall, well, to Brickell Center, which is I think about 15 to 20 minutes away from my hotel. I have some stuff, they close at 9, so I would have basically like, let's say hopefully I get out of the airport in an hour. And the hotel is very close to the airport. So let's say I get to Brickell for 7:30. Then I'll pretty much just have like an hour and a half to like get all the last minute bits that I want to get. I have a whole day tomorrow to go to the mall, but I want to go to a different mall from Brickell Center. Somebody was telling me about going to Adventura Mall. But anyway, but also too, there's this event happening tonight. And I know some of the guys who are going to be like DJing and whatever, because you know, you guys know I do work in the entertainment industry, because I do have an entertainment company and I've worked with other entertainment companies, so you know, you get to know these people all the time and stuff like that. So we'll see if I end up there. And also, as I've said before, I like looking somewhat decent and presentable when I go to the airport, because you meet a lot of people in the airport. Yeah, some people that you're never going to meet again, but I've literally had, like, my cousin is married to her husband and she literally met her husband in an airport. I have another friend who, like, her current boyfriend, she met him in an airport too. Like, they literally were in the line together chatting it up. They were going to two different destinations. It was such a love story. And well, it's a love story, they're still together. And literally he left, like, after they had parted ways and went to their gates, she was like, you know, this was cute or whatever, you know, probably never gonna see that guy again. He came back to her gate and asked for her number. Like, they were actually from the same original country. So they met up again and stuff like that, and now they're in a full-blown relationship, you know? We love to see it. So I'm not saying I'm going to the airport looking for love or anything like that, but like literally, when you put a little bit of effort into yourself, no matter where you're going, like you just don't know who you're going to meet. Like, you know, when you're in the airport, people are traveling for business. You know, you can meet people that could be like your next job, your next client. And especially like me, because I have my own companies and stuff like that, it is very important, like building that clientele. And people treat you better when you look nice. it's just an unconscious human bias. People treat you better when you look good. Yeah, my uniform for the airport now is literally like this bodysuit with some sort of trousers. But like before, I literally was just like a hoodie and sweatpants type of gal. And I mean, yeah, I was still cute, but you know, I'm a little bit older now, so I like to look a little bit more, you know, elevated. I feel like the same way I would dress cute to go to a cafe, you know, I'm gonna dress cute and comfy to go to an airport, you know? I just feel like taking myself that much more seriously this morning. But anyway, I just ran out of space on my memory card. If y'all ever want to get me a gift, please, memory cards, please, please, please. I just go through them. But some of my memory cards form kind of like time capsules for me in a way, you know? So like the videos that I really, really like and the memories that I really want, I keep them on the card. And then when that card is just like absolutely full of memories and nothing that I would want to erase, I just get a new card, you know? I don't like deleting all my stuff from memory cards. So I'm just gonna finish getting ready and then drive up to the airport. I have a rental, so I'm gonna drop that off when I get up there. And Dominica was really nice. I hope to see it again soon. You know, through my job, we do have field work and stuff that's coming up here relatively soon. So I hope to be back. Maybe then when I'm back, I will be back for longer. So even though I'm working, I will still have that nice little balance where I can do stuff, you know, because I could have done stuff this weekend, but the weather was just awful. And you know what my friends were telling me, like June, July, they were saying it was basically a drought in Dominica. Like they were saying there was no rain, the place was dry, the place was hot. And they're like, so they were actually so grateful for that downpour of rain this weekend. And I'm just like, but the one weekend that I'm there and I just want to lay up on a beach and go to Purple Turtle or go to Toucarie and just be all up in the water. The weather was terrible. And surprisingly, the weather was a bit better yesterday, but you know, we were going out on the field, so I didn't hold my swimsuit or nothing like that. And then when we got to Toucarie, I was like, all right, I'ma get a little lobster, you know, for old time's sake. And there was like no food. I was just like, why are you even open if you have no food that's gonna be ready within 2 hours? Like, to me, you might as well just stay closed. So it was just really nice. And then I love to see all the development in my country, you know, like Fort Chang and everything. Dominica is definitely up there and going places, you know? So yeah, this is the outfit of the day. I'm literally just wearing my black Zara bodysuit. I think I'm going to pick up another one in Zara. And these are my trousers. They're really comfortable. And I like how these like dad trousers fit. Like they're just so lax. But they can look professional and dressed up. But I can literally put like my Converse on and tone it down. And it's still giving chic. But I like this look because if I don't change when I get to the hotel, like I could literally just go straight to Brickell like this, put on some sandals, and just be cute and ready, you know? Anyway, I'll catch up with you guys soon.